Ladies and gentlemen, and to lots of shocking news today in this episode. So we are going to talk about something really everyone knows actually some of these news, but it is actually becoming more and more clearer right now. So we're going to deal with the news that are getting too much clearer. So James Ollie says that Alex Lacazette currently has no contract offer to consider from Arsenal. Arteta insists he remains part of his plans and unclear whether the club will change stance in weeks ahead, but several European clubs are circling around as of January, ahead of January. So Lacazette might be leaving Arsenal. He could be, you know, most probably I think would agree a deal in January with other clubs. He's open to that, so that might definitely happen. But moving on, Arsenal's, I think, fourth choice goalkeeper, Carl Hein, who is Estonian international goalkeeper, has signed a new long-term contract with Arsenal. He recently put up a very good show as well. So fantastic Carl Hein, 19-year-old, who has made his non-competitive first team debut in July in the preseason game at Hibernian as well. So, and also his first team match scored 6 times in Europa League last season as well. But more importantly, Hein hit the headlines last week with an outstanding performance for Estonia as they held Wales to a goalless draw. He had some, a lot of saves as well. So what did Carl Hein has to say about his contract extension? He says, signing a new professional contract. He says, it means a lot to extend my contract with this big club, a big club in Europe, a massive club with traditions. I'm very, very happy. It's been a long process. First year, I had quite a long-term injury with my wrist. It was a tough time, but I think I went through it well. Next season was good, did well with the 23s, and then step by step I got involved in the national team, got involved more with the first team, and slowly but surely it's been good progress. My ambitions are to play for Arsenal, ultimately train hard and keep the progress going, and then hopefully get my chance. Step by step, every day I feel more comfortable, and it's been a good preseason, and I'm looking forward to this season. You know what, if Bernd Leno gets officially sold off probably in the upcoming transfer windows, I'm expecting someone like Carl Hein, because Arthur Okonkwo, I don't know when he's going to play international football, but more importantly, Carl Hein has already stamped his authority to play for Estonia. So if that goes on, and Arsenal's policy, young players who have some decent amount of experience with the international team, Carl Hein could be Arsenal's either number second or third goalkeeper in the near future. I'd love to see that, man. I'd really do acknowledge that. Moving on, so Chris Wheatley opened up recently about the whole Yves Bissouma. He actually went to Latte FM, and there was a lot of things that he opened up about. So about Yves Bissouma, he says, I don't think there was any approach for him this summer. The last formal contact with the player of his with his representatives was in January. I don't think Bissouma is one that is likely to happen anytime soon, but it's a transfer window. But more importantly, what does Yves Bissouma have to say about his whole Arsenal, he's sending out, he's got some latest Brighton, he reached a latest Brighton milestone. He amassed 100 Brighton appearances in just over 3 seasons. So he says, I'm very proud and happy. It's been a long time working hard. It's down to everyone at the club. I want to say thanks to those people and to the club. It's amazing to be a part of the best league in the world. When I came in here, I was 21 and now I'm 25. So I have matured as a person and in my game. I learned a lot of things in those early years. So Yves Bissouma says he's mature enough. But is he mature enough to join a new club? That's a big question. So Chris Wheatley also opened up about Arsenal's chances of signing Alex Ishak. He says, not impossible. I don't think anything is impossible when you're a club like Arsenal. Arsenal certainly do have the money to spend. I don't think it's one that's likely to happen anytime soon, but he is one Arteta likes. Arteta loves Alexander Ishak. Likes. I'm sorry. I just clickbaited you guys right in the middle of a video. My God. Anyways, so Chris Wheatley opened up about Charlie Patino. He says, I know he's going to be signing an add-on contract next month when he turns 18. He's staying at the club. There were some links like Barcelona. We don't have to worry about that. He's staying at Arsenal. I've said for the past year or so that this kid is going to be the next big thing out of the academy. Everyone inside the club and lots of coaches, scouts have known about Charlie for a long time. He's really talented. Technically, he's fantastic for his age. His dad's parents are Spanish and he's got that Spanish flair. I know that he idolizes Xavi and Iniesta. I would expect him to be in the squad for the Carabao Cup game versus Wimbledon. I know a lot of players in the first team are really impressed with him. I think Ben White has given him advice. Alex Lacazette has taken him aside, and they're really impressed with what they're seeing, and so is Mikel Arteta. And talking about the Cronkies and Mikel Arteta, Chris Wheatley says, I don't think the Cronkies have any intention of sacking Mikel Arteta. He's very close with Josh Kroenke, more close than any previous manager, you could argue. I think that really benefits him in terms of his position. The key man at Arsenal at the moment is Tim Lewis. He has been the key man for the past year. He's the reason Raul Sanyehi ended up losing his job. And he's the reason a lot of cuts have been made as well, staff and players. So now you know who's responsible for everything. It's Tim Lewis, ladies and gentlemen. And those are the reasons why. So, ladies and gentlemen, Arsenal legend and invincible Freddie Ljungberg has been included in FIFA 22 Ultimate Team Hero. You can see Cahill, Cole, Durek, Erkin. Sorry. Oh my God. It's Solskjaer. Oh my God. Cole, Cahill. It's Solskjaer. I got it wrong. So, Ljungberg is also there, ladies and gentlemen. That's really, really crazy stuff. Well, did you know? Here's a fun trivia. I don't even know that you guys needed this trivia or not, but there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Arsenal's current back four is the tallest in the club's Premier League history. Tallest. I don't know what you will do with that information. I did not know what to do with that information, so I thought, why not? Just help. Let me help you guys out of it. So Gabriel Magalhães versus Alex Lacazette. If you can see the aerial duels won by Gabby. Martin Odegaard, there's Takehiro Tomiyasu, there's Saka, I think that's Ben White at the background. And there you go, Kieran Tierney being pictured in today's training as well, ladies and gentlemen. So, and you can see Folarin Balogun getting involved in the Rondo. There is Emil Smith Rowe, and I can see Ainsley Maitland-Niles as well. And there's Bukayo Saka as well. So, Eddie Nketiah also being a part of the Rondo. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's that about the training images. And there we go, Nicola Pepe. Gabriel Martinelli and Nuno Tavares. Let's see how things will turn out. But moving on, Arteta has spoken about Ben White. He says, I think he has adapted incredibly well to our way of playing, to the boys and to what this club is all about. I am very pleased with him. So that's something special that you can see from Ben White, hopefully against Burnley as well. Well, you got to speak about it. That's a problem, you know. Now, the best part of the video. No, I'm not going to talk about Vlahovic. I am going to talk about... Chris Wheatley shared this, you know. Sven-Goran Eriksson spoke to the Italian football podcast. So, Sven-Goran Eriksson said, Gary Neville is a professional moaner on everything. Moaner. M-O-A-N-E-R. Okay, listen to it. Listen to me carefully. Gary Neville is a professional moaner on everything. Beckham told me during one of his first England sessions, boss, don't listen to him. He was born like that and he'll die like that. But he's a good man and he doesn't really mean what he says. This is exactly what everyone should believe about Gary Neville, you know. Unbelievable. That's a perfect reiteration of who he is. That's really crazy, isn't it? I love it. I love to see it, man. I love to see it. Unbelievable. Also, Chris Wheatley also shared this, Karl Heinz. Talented goalkeeper, already a senior Estonia international, signed a new contract with Arsenal. Taylor Hart, Okonkwo and Hine, all committing their futures over the past few months. And as we speak, ladies and gentlemen, Michael Owen and Mark Lawrenson send Arsenal a warning ahead of the Burnley clash. So they say that both think that Arsenal will drop points in the clash against Burnley. So speaking to Beck Victor, Michael Owen says, Arsenal may have got the win against Norwich, but I'm still not overly impressed with them. A club like Arsenal should be scoring a lot more than just one goal through the opening four games. There's been a lot of changes in the team and settled side should help them. Turf Moor will be in good voice for this game. Those fans love the visit of the big teams and Arsenal are always vulnerable on these sorts of away trips. I fancy Burnley to get a vital 3 points here. Lawrenson says, Sean Dyche's new contract is great news for Burnley. They need him more than ever this season if they're going to stay up. The Clarets played well against Everton on Monday, just like they did against Liverpool at the start of the season, but they did not get anything out of either of the games. I think that might change on Saturday though. Arsenal got the first goal and a first win against Norwich, but this is going to be a very different game and it will be a real test for them. 100% agreed. But moving on, let's talk about Arsenal and Manchester City have received a huge transfer boost with Fiorentina's chief admitting Dusan Vlahovic could leave the club if he does not sign a new deal. The 21-year-old Serbian striker is Serie A's best young talents and has been heavily linked with a move to the Premier League after emerging as a target for both Man City and Arsenal over the summer. Vlahovic, netting 21 goals in 37 Serie A games for Fiorentina, was reportedly a target for a lot of clubs, but Spurs were ahead of everyone if they were to suppose to replace Harry Kane. Atletico Madrid also offered £51 million, which was rejected. Of course, they were holding out for it, but let's see. Well, Fiorentina are desperate to keep hold of their prized asset, but chief Rocco Commisso has now admitted that the Serbian could be sold for the right price. He says the right offer has not arrived, and although I do not think he will leave, we plan to give him a contract the richest in the history of Fiorentina. I'm happy for him because they are really important figures, and if he wants to leave next year, we'll talk about it. He has to understand that if he gets that much money, he owes it to this team. There are teams interested in him, but I have not set prices. I want him to stay another year. His current deal expires in June 2023, and the club will hope to tie him for a long-term deal to maximize his value and guard against the possibility of him leaving for free. Let's see where will Vlahovic stay, where will he go? Nobody knows, but let's see what happens in the future. So with this, I'd like to end this episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. I will see you in the next one. Until then, cheers.